Hi, and welcome to Event Lighting. Welcome to another tutorial on GrandMA3. This time we're going to look at how you can change some of your fixtures, you can copy some of your fixtures, and you can paste them in. That could be if you're on tour and you have your whole setup from when you practice somewhere or from your 3D visualizer. Then you come out on the road and you want to change the fixtures to a different type. And that is actually extremely simple on GrandMA3. So let's get into it. As you can see here, I have patched some Aura XBs. There's 10 of them in the patch. They are already on. And I have a cue list here, or a sequence here, with some colors in it and a position. Over here, we have a few bump cues, or just a simple bump cue. But we can change these ones to a different type. We can copy them and paste them into the same show. So right now, we go into our settings up here. We go into the patch. And you can see in here, I have 10 Aura XBs patched. What I can do is I can highlight the 10 of them here. I can say copy. I can go into new fixture and I can paste them in again. Now you can see I have 10 extra Aura XBs. And there's a few things we need to fix first. First of all, we need to change the patch up here because the patch, because we copy and paste the fixture, the patch is identical, which doesn't work. So we need to change the patch from universe 1, and we can say we need it into universe number 2. So it gets the same addresses, 1, 15, 29, and so on universe 2 instead of universe 1. And another thing we need to check is the unit numbers. We copied the unit numbers here, and it pasted no unit numbers because there can't be identical unit numbers in GrandMA. So we highlight all the unit numbers here and we select 101, and now we have fixtures 1 through 10 and 101 through 110. We can exit the patch just to check if everything is working. Right now we have all our fixtures here selected, and now I can say 101 through 110 and select them, go into setup and move them a little bit further down, and now you can see we have exactly the same amount of fixtures. They have exactly the same color, and if I go into the sequence here, they do exactly the same, even though we copied them. They are brand new fixtures, but they are told to do exactly as the other ones. So what we can do now is go into the patch again. We can say patch, we can select all the new ones here, and we can say I want to change the type, I want a different type of fixture. Since this is a wash fixture, we could search for, we could select ProLights. We could search for ProLights wash, for instance, on our library here. We have a Pixie Wash XB. We put it into a 13 channel mode and we select this and we exit, save. Now we change the type from our XBs into ProLight fixture, Pixie fixture. And as you can see here, if I go my cue list, it's going to do exactly the same thing. So now we added 10 extra fixtures. Without any work, it does exactly the same as before. So that's the power of copy and pasting fixtures on GrandMA3. And do me a favor, if you like these videos on event lighting, please give the video a like. That is going to help it spread out to more people on YouTube. And check out some of the links we have in the bottom of the description. I have a online school coming up. If you are a brand new user of GrandMA3 and you want to learn, and this is maybe a little bit too complex for you, you want to start over and you want to learn everything from the bottom up, I suggest you sign on to the email list we have down below, and I will update you on the progress of the school as soon as we launch it, and with news and other stuff as well. And if you want to join our GrandMA3 community, we have a Discord server you can join. There's also a link down there in the description where you can join our Discord server and you can get help from other people. And if you are a more seasoned user, you can help other people as well. So I'm trying to build this community, as I don't know everything, and a lot of people know something, and that depends on where you work in the console. So if you are a experienced user, please sign up as well and help me help some other new people in there. I hope to see you in the next video, which you can see on the screen right here, where you can get even more tips on GrandMA3. And until I see you next time, I hope you have a happy GrandMA3 programming session. Thank you very much. See you later. Bye.